As you probably know, the GPU is often the most important component of a PC when you're trying to run a game. So, if you often stare at your Intel Celeron or i3 or i5 laptop with Intel HD and think, is there any way I can put a better GPU in this thing? The answer is usually a big no. Laptops provide a ton of portability at the expense of upgradability. Some of the newer models have made great advances in this regard. Razer introduced the Razer Core, a device that allows the connection of an external graphics card to some of the Razer laptops, which costs enough to build an entire computer. Or there's also the Alienware graphics amplifier for some Alienware laptops, and they're now often thought of similar adapters compatible with all sorts of computers. One problem though, this modern solution requires USB Type-C with Thunderbolt 3, a rather modern connection that you will be hard-pressed to find on old or low-end laptops. This is why when I discovered some Chinese companies were making GPU adapters over mini PCIe, my curiosity piqued. This is a laptop external independent video card dock made by EXP GDC, an inexpensive device, especially if you compare it with a Razer Core. Seriously, what were they thinking? That promises to enable external GPUs on old laptops. You can get one over at online store Banggood, which sent me this very device for reviewing purposes, link in the description. You can connect an external GPU to this PCIe base. To power the entire contraption, you need to connect this included cable to an ATX power source. You know, the same power source you will use to power a full tower computer. Now, to connect it to a computer, you use a special HDMI cable. I'm not sure the HDMI standard was made for this kind of use, but alright. The store has two cables to connect to this bizarre HDMI port. One goes to mini PCIe and the other goes to express card. I have never seen a computer with an express card port, so I went for a mini PCIe. Since I'm a crazy person, I decided to create the most unbalanced system ever seen and try to connect it to this thing. This is a EEE PC1000, a netbook laptop from 2008 rocking an Intel Atom N270. This is not one of those new fancy Intel Atoms on the Intel sticks, nope. This is the old Atom, the one that had problems even running Windows. It is hard for me to convey just how bad the things were. I struggled to get Half-Life 2 to even start on it. So let's add an external GPU to this computer and see what happens. If you have never opened a laptop before, usually the mini PCIe port is used for the Wi-Fi adapter. So if you're willing to connect over Ethernet, you can remove your own Wi-Fi adapter and connect this cable to that port, and then the HDMI side into the back. Usually, mini PCIe ports are small enough that you can screw the connector into place using these two holes. If the area in the port is too long for that, you can buy an adapter to reach the holes, or if you're already spent too much on this project, you can be like me and tape it into place. YouTuber LowSpecGamer makes a living out of making games playable on the weakest computers, reducing games to their most basic visual components so they can run on rigs made out of balsa wood and held together with duct tape. Yep, seems about right. I'm going to use the Nvidia 640 on this base. This is an entry-level GPU from 2012 that struggles with recently released games, but should do fine for older games. Installing this device is a bit of a process. When you start the computer again, you should see Windows trying to install the drivers for the base through Windows Update, and once those are done, you need to install the drivers for that specific card. It took me some time playing around with Device Manager and the connector to make it work, so your results might vary. Once done, I was left with this franking computer outputting video from the HDMI on the GPU, and now we test. 2D indie games seem to present no problem for this setup, as you might have guessed. You might see some moments here and there where games freeze in order to load, but in general, 2D games are fine. Now, as I said before, I had issues trying Half-Life 2 under any circumstances on this laptop, which is why I was pleasantly surprised when I was able to reach almost 40 FPS on a random indoor area while playing on 720 on the lowest settings. Interesting. If you have seen my videos before, you might recall that I created a configuration file that reduces the graphics to their absolute bizarre minimum. So I decided to load that up to see how it will go, and as you can see, the result is actually really good. You can see that there are moments when the extraordinarily slow CPU has trouble keeping up, but with some effort, the game can be played on this setup. I also wanted to try Portal 2, another performance-friendly game, but one that is significantly heavier than Half-Life 2. This setup did better than I expected, with performance on around 15 FPS while in the test chambers. Loading up a super low configuration file got us closer to 20, but we're hitting that CPU bottleneck harder and harder. But hey, this is already farther than I expected to get. But just because I was curious, I decided to finish this with Skyrim, a game that is unthinkable in a netbook, and I got 10 to 19 FPS. Well, that is 18 FPS more than I expected. Evidently, using a super low graphics mod is not going to help on those extremes, but it is interesting that we managed to get this far. So, in conclusion, the main issue I see with this procedure is that it requires you to take apart your laptop a bit, and then it requires a bunch of cables to get working, but the whole experiment was more interesting than I expected, and it got this piece of shit to run two games that I never expected it to achieve. So if you have an old laptop and a bunch of PC components laying around, and you want to build a new computer out of it, this is actually a really good choice. Thank you once again to Banggood for sending me this device for review, and also a big thanks to them for sending me this small SSD hard drive. If you follow me on social networks, you might know that I have been complaining about my hard drive issues. I have built computers with some of the cheapest components in Amazon, and my only regret is this bloody thing that takes half an hour to boot or open any game. Never, never buy the cheapest hard drive in Amazon for a Windows 10 computer. So now, I'll be using this one and getting videos done faster. Thank you to all Patreon donors as well for making it easier for me to make videos. See you on the next one.